Even though a commission of inquiry has been tabled on the floor of Parliament, no further action has been taken to apprehend those in the wrong, a dilemma which parent Reverend Oalabaru Arua says is not helping families find closure. Mr. Arua lost his son, an engineer, on the ship.
Up to today, all we have heard is that the police department is still waiting for funds to conduct their own investigation. What investigation are we talking about? This is what, in a way, frustrates and angers us, because the Commission of Inquiry is very clear. It is clear. It is clear and also implicit that somebody was arrogant, somebody broke the law.
He says morally part blame lies with the government and maritime authorities who failed to monitor the condition of ships. Last November, the initial steps of a class action against Rabaul Shipping and agencies of government, including the National Maritime Safety Authority, was instigated.
No head has rolled now in this disaster. That's a pity. It's a real pity. Because what does that show us now? I'm sorry, Mosem. Mibla, talk, nothing. And then we just allow them to continue.
As the date of the first anniversary nears, Reverend Oala is making a support call to all the governors of the victims involved in the disaster. Police Commissioner Tom Kulunga says a lack of funding is the main reason for the delay in implementing recommendations. 2 million kina is needed. But Prime Minister Peter O'Neill says the police don't need extra funding. It's in their job description to make the relevant arrests. Meredith Kusa, National, MTV News.